flat finishing operation. In ZW3D 2017, there is a new operation called flat finishing to make planar surface programming more efficient and more reliable. The new flat finishing operation can detect all the planar surfaces within a given flat tolerance automatically, and then create toolpath for all planar surfaces in one operation, or create a toolpath for the planar surfaces within limiting parameters. Let's take a mold part as an example. First, create the flat finishing operations. In the Quick Mill tab, click Flat. Right-click Tool Node to select D6R0 as the machining tool. Right-click Feature Node, then click Add. In the pop-up, click the Create button and OK. Then pick the part in the work area. Middle-click to finish the selection. And then click OK in the Feature form to finish the flat region feature creation. Right-click on the Finishing 1 operation and click Calculate. We then get a flat finishing toolpath on all of the planar surfaces quickly. There are two path pattern types supported in this operation. One is lace and the other is offset 2D. Let's duplicate the operation. Open the parameter form. Change path pattern type to offset 2D. Then click the Calculate button. Now, an offset 2D path pattern is generated. The flat finishing operation also supports using the reference tool function to clean up the corner of a planar face with a smaller cutter referring to a big cutter. Let's duplicate the flat finish 2 operation. Change the cutter from D6R0 to D3R0. Then open the parameter form to choose D6R0 as a reference tool. Then click Calculate to generate the cleanup toolpath. Let's zoom in and rotate the part to view the toolpath more clearly. So, with the new dedicated flat finishing operation, we can program toolpaths for planar surfaces more efficiently and with more reliability.